As long as Lord uses his
like,
hands, he should be okay.
Oh, hold on, they'll do the rest.
Dark!
Yes?
It's not because I have been preparing, not at all.
Okay.
Magical pony, yeah.
My little pony.
Bart no, I'm sitting on
rides
the
a magical white
that
pony.
That one.
Arrange.
Okay, alright, there we go.
I'm sitting on that one.
Alright. My little pony.
You can't sit on the head.
Yeah, what are you doing?
God damn it.
You're such a noob.
And you all ride with your special horses.
Yay!
Pollard has to sit next to him.
Riv is not surprised about anything right now.
I'm so happy I got to use that token.
By the way, Haldimir, you can just change the image by just, like, if you double-click the token and then drag it from the folder on. I didn't know if you knew because you just, like, dropped it into the...
Yeah, I'll do it in a bit.
Yeah, a little...
No, I don't blame you. I'm just saying.
Okay,
yeah, a little bit of...
Is anything really interesting is going to happen now because I have toast in the oven?
Nope. I don't know.
The oven?
I don't know, it could do. It could be. Could be super interesting.
I need to get it
just
now.
Just go get it. Go get it.
Okay,
go get it.
Okay.
Go. Run.
Yeah, you all ride and get back here. The world explodes. No.
The world explodes. Cthulhu just shows up and that's it.
Yeah, you ride back and as you're all here, at least most of you are here, maybe Raphael might be like on his horse still. She dispels all the horses.
Raphael just falls to the ground. Oh my god!
Just like, whoa!
Acrobatics check.
He could make it.
Can he, though?
Can he? I'm gonna do it.
Acrobatics are pretty good.
I'm way ahead of you, man.
32!
Hold it.
He makes it.
He's good acrobatics.
Nah, he doesn't make it. The DC was 31. So saith Drake.
We take the first roll, though.
Well, yeah, but, you know okay, that. Then the DC's 33. He doesn't make it. So saith Jake.
On the DM, I say he manages to draw 44 on his butt.
No, of course, because he falls on his face.
With that 32, he does,
okay,
like, a backflip.
So Raphael got... The horses got dispelled and Raphael got knocked on his butt.
That's about it.
Like, basically, everyone was dismounting at the time, but Raphael hadn't finished dismounting and she dispelled all the horses.
When did the horses go?
Because you got back to the building.
Aww.
Oh, back to the building. That's it. I'll buy you a horse if you really want one.
I think I have the money.
I have a fucking celestial hawk now.
But yeah, you get back to the building. Caridel informs you she's going to go straight to her laboratory, but dinner will be served in a few hours.
Riff will totally go with. Like, practically running behind.
Are Pollard and Laurel going down to the camp or up to the building?
Yeah, well, let's go down here and cook the basilisk stuff, right?
Yeah.
Well, Riff sees her library divided into three sections, or I should say her laboratory is. She has a huge...
So I will come too. She doesn't want to look at the guys doing the basilisk thing.
Raphael's going to go, like, hang out in his bed.
The guy does, if we need rolls.
He said he has no use in being in the laboratory.
Yeah, he's going to cook with the men. Man stuff.
Yeah, it's woman's business and man's business.
I think he's more like going to stand in the edge of the water and do water dancing.
He's going to be training with the water. There we go.
So, yeah, this area is divided into three sections. There's a huge library down here.
Oh.
It's a large, like, arcane laboratory where right now you can see, like, glowing instruments and what, Riff would definitely recognize as, like, enchanting tables and enchanting books.
Okay.
And last thing is, appears to be a set of, a set of beakers with something bubbling in them. Some alchemical stuff. So very similar to what Laurel looks like he's made in the past.
What is it?
Do you have knowledge of alchemy?
No.
You don't know what's bubbling in that.
I have herbalist.
Maybe you know with herbalist. You can roll. You take a minus -5.
Aw, dude.
Yes.
Guide, yeah.
You still rolling or not?
I'm still rolling.
Okay.
I'm just moving my food while I do it. Minus -5?
Yes. Because... No, you just have no idea.
That's Kool-Aid!
It's potatoes.
But yeah, she immediately rushed into her library, which seems to have a huge symbol marked on the wall as well.
What kind is of the symbol?
Detect magic.
Do any of you have religion?
Heck yeah.
Zoe has religion, which she failed earlier. I'd like to point
out. No, she didn't.
Totally did. You did 14.
Well, you do recognize this symbol. It's a rather popular symbol. It's you know, it's a mask that's split in two, and one side's black, one side's white. The symbol of Nethus, the god of all magic in the universe.
Oh, that guy.
Yeah. Well, Riff would know that, being that's his, that's her deity.
Yes.
She'd totally point at it and go, hey, that's Nephis.
Yeah, Nephis is known for being a very indecisive god, where one moment he might try destroying the world with magic, then the next moment he might try building entire cities with it.
Yeah, he's a bit mental.
He has a title of the All-Seeing Eye, where he knows everything that's going on, even the actions of the gods.
Powerful ally he is.
He's omniscient. No, not omnipotent.
Alright, Riff, we'll ask Caradel if there's anything that she can do to help.
Currently she's digging through books in her library. Well, right, I'm going to do some research. I'm very curious on the subject. Any lead possible might be useful. You can have a look around as well if you want, or if you have work to do. My equipment's available to you over there.
Riffle, have a look.
Yes, you guys are going to a study. You'll get a PM about whatever your results are.
Yeah.
Zoe will assist Riffle in whatever she needs.
Very well, you'll both get a PM of what you find out. Later.
Yeah.
Yay.
So as you dig through books.
Yeah.
Lots of books.
Lots of books.
And, the day turns to, the day turns to night. Who's eating dinner in the manor?
So he is.
Riffle, take a meal to go.
Okay.
Raphael's probably as well. Lauren Bullard out.
So in the manor, you're being served you're being served some noodles and some curry. So, you know, not something you really get in the Empire normally, actually. It actually tastes really delicious to most of you. If any of you don't like spice, then you know, she'll get something will turn out for you. Yeah, some quite nice spicy noodles. She also offers you, a drink of your choice. Some tea, she recommends.
Riff will have some tea.
Sure.
Riff might ask Laurel for that tea of meditation.
Alright, it's not a cheap thing.
Riff will pay the expense, if you really wish.
Alright, sure.
You know, she doesn't mind too.
Meanwhile, what's being served for dinner down in the camp?
Basilisk, elk.
Yeah, basilisk and elk.
Describe, how has it been prepared?
A Laurel make
a lovely
elk,
stew.
Meat basilisk.
A basilisk stew?
Mm-hmm.
Basilisk stew.
How's the elk been prepared?
Currently diced and then heavily spiced into little cubes, spiced meat that's then been roasted on little spits.
Interesting.
Kebab, yeah?
Basically,
elk kebab.
So elk and bad kebab and basilisk stew. Basilisk meat is very, very tough.
Yeah, it's going to be like chewing
on... Not when you tenderize it with an earthbreaker.
It's still pretty damn tough.
I mean, I'm pretty sure that prestidigitation cannot change the texture of stuff, but, you know.
It cannot change it that far, that's for sure.
Yeah.
But, you know, It might be tough meat, but, you know, in the stew, it goes down quite well.
It's fresh meat.
It's very fresh. But yeah, the evening passes, and who sleeps outside, who sleeps inside, for my knowledge?
Inside.
Inside.
I think Roland and Pollard sleep in the tent.
Well, sheep is the main thing, I guess. Sheep? Raphael, sleep inside or outside?
Wherever the most ladies are.
Inside.
Well, there are three, inside. There are three ladies inside and zero ladies outside.
Perfect, inside then.
Very well.
They're all in one area as well.
Well, you know, everyone inside, you know, the beds are actually really comfortable. Outside.
Depending on where what Riff finds out, she might not sleep.
Near the water, maybe not. Near the waterfall.
Wait, one quick.
Laurel's awake all night, right?
You know, you'll actually go sleep a little early. You know, same time as Ballard.
Would you say your character would be probably awake about 3 a.m.?
Yeah, I'll just be done sleeping at that point.
So, yeah, can you make me a perception check?
Sure.
Question, does Nairu now glow?
Does not glow like a candle.
Damn it.
She can choose to.
Wait, what?
Nairu may choose to glow like a candle if she wishes.
He may want to help.
Like 5 foot of light.
There we go. He can help me read.
Like a nightlight.
Do you want?
Yeah.
You see a large shape moving through the sky in the distance.
Dragon?
What does it appear to be?
What
sort of shape?
Winged.
What sort of wings? Feathery or leathery?
It's quite distant. Can you make me an arcana check?
Oh, sure. Dragon. As soon as I've deactivated the mage armor, that active mouse is using.
No, I need to change Naru's AC, actually. It's gone up recently.
And the token picture.
And the token.
As bird shedding crystal feathers, yeah. Well, let's see here. Fucking sucky 3 again.
You're not too sure? It's quite far away, but big. Really big.
You know, what you should do is at least I would do. Yeah, just like shake his shoulder excitedly. Ballard, Ballard, look.
Oh, take a look at that.
Yeah.
The tired Ballard make his voice organic.
Oh.
Ballard is not really an expert in this subject. His expertise are aberrations.
Yeah.
However,
that's a flying ooze, man.
You can't really put an exact on it. The shape is very reptilian.
Like, dragony?
Possibly draconic, you're not sure.
Well, I mean, it's a flying lizard. Ballard thinks it's a dragon.
You can definitely take that assumption.
Mm-hmm. That's what I'm going with. Ballard is going to say, I think it's a dragon. It looks reptilian. I don't know any other lizards that can fly.
Wizards that can fly, all of them.
Pseudo dragon. It could just be a pseudo dragon really close by.
Laurel doesn't have a spyglass, so.
You do or you don't?
No, he doesn't, so what does he know?
If you did have one!
I haven't bought one, so. I've made lots of alchemical things, but none of them allow me to make alchemical. I don't know.
All you would need is some powdered glass and then melt it together.
That's not alchemy, that's glass.
That's glass working.
You could do it alchemically, though.
Also, making a good lens is...
Yeah, that's the hard part.
You'd need, like, a circular centrifuge to create the perfectly bent edge.
But yeah, you see that moving around for a while and dive into the forest.
Where over? Just like, could I like?
But basically, this lower section of forest in the mountains mostly.
Okay.
Yeah, if we go sleep over there, then we'll be able to see it.
Mm-hmm. Or you know, get eaten by it.
Get what?
Eaten.
It seems to keep flying around for quite a while. Like, you're probably about from 3 a.m. to about 4 a.m.
Does it dive down violently, eating something?
Dive down violently, you can't tell if it's eating anything.
Alright.
So you're kind of quite far away.
It's an assumption.
Just it might be eating something. It's probably eating.
After that time...
Does it have a tail?
It does have a tail.
Oh, okay.
I'm pretty sure it's
a totally dragon.
What? Collar, is it in the dark?
You got a silhouette.
When it moved down, did it do so sort of head first or feet first? Like basically as like a hawk going for grabbing something, or?
I don't actually know. I have to double check that.
How many legs does it have? I can give you the answer.
Well, if it's just going to land, then it's going to still go feet, like, back feet first.
Yeah.
So, still valid, you know. Stuffs.
It's more of, is it dangerous to be over there? Mm-hmm. Is it, it's like, oh, I just need to bathe a little bit in this little pond, or it's like, oh, I want to kill anything that's in here. It's my land.
I mean, sometimes it dives down, sometimes it lands.
Right.
Berries.
Dragon eagle.
Yeah, it seemed, you know, after about an hour or so, it seems to fly on the other side of the mountain and disappear.
No breath weapon, no. All right. It's a good sign. Well, Lord, sort of that was interesting. A little fantastic for his taste.
Hmm.
Reset my spell counter.
God.
Yeah, with that, you guys wake up in the morning. Rift might still be in the library, like covered in books right now.
And there's random handprints along the walls and seats where she's been around, like reading the books, that are glowing. So you know.
Then you go down the camps also wake up. Bullard actually wakes up to like some creature sniffing him.
Oh.
Bullard?
Bullard. Headbutt.
Breakfast.
Some yeah, there, to be besides, it seems to be a ferret.
Headbutt.
Oh, should I grab it?
Yeah, grab the
like
thing.
By the neck. And squeeze really, really hard.
By the neck. Make a grapple check.
Why are you doing that? It's just a
because
ferret.
Because I'm gonna eat it!
Don't eat the ferret! Sora will never forgive you if you eat the ferret.
That's not my problem. If I'm hungry and the ferret's presenting itself to me.
That means she's never gonna heal you again.
Well, you don't know about this.
Yeah, how are you gonna know? This is breakfast. Where is the special?
Special.
Okay. Yep.
What you know, Anna.
Wait, so for variant size modifier, do I put my size or their size?
You're putting the difference in size, really, what you need for this. To balance this out.
Are they small or tiny?
Tiny, I believe.
Yeah, that's a two.
It counts as.
So I put tiny on here, or I put small
you,
on here?
You're gonna put your, what you would be in relative in this case. I want you to.
Wait, what?
Because huge relative to it.
Oh, yes, huge relative huge, to it, yeah. Okay.
So yeah, because...
You take it as medium, and then you add the...
Yeah. Yeah. If it were colossal and I was medium, I would put, like, fine. Okay.
You would know. Zoe told you that her stepmom heard
tiny... Yeah, you grappled it.
I've grappled it.
Heard tiny animals in front of her.
Zoe doesn't know that. I eat the ferret. I break its neck. Can I just, like, do that?
Yeah, you can break its neck.
Okay.
Doesn't have much health.
I was gonna say, Laurel's totally gonna be awake. I was gonna say, if he's still asleep, I cook it up and then
he's like outside.
Mm-hmm.
He's been awake for like hours,
maybe having a shower under the cold waterfall.
Walked a little around, you know, picked some local herbs and whatnot, made some tea.
You get some decent local herbs. A lot of it's stuff which you normally have to import, because it's normally like, you know,
oh, then he has like plucked tons of this shit.
What is it, survival to skin it?
Yeah, survival to skin.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to skin it.
That's enough.
Yep, and then I will cook it. You know, get rid of all the bad bits.
Yeah, we've kept the fire going.
Mm-hmm. Make myself some ferret bacon.
Like, in the morning, though, everyone inside the place, is, everyone inside the main place is given, you know, they're given a choice of what they want for breakfast. Yeah, whatever you might desire, you know, probably cooked up.
Super nice lady.
She doesn't really, like, you know, she's quite frantically gets whatever you want for breakfast sorted out and then quickly goes back down to the library again.
With, like, a bowl of food for Riff as well.
Yes. But yeah, you know, after about half a day or so, both Riff and, Carol, and I guess Zoe as well, all come back upstairs. Seemingly exhausted everything her library has on this specific subject.
Mm-hmm.
And she informs you that she's planning on riding towards the capital. She needs to do some research in the archives.
We offer a trip back until we wish to stop off. If we wish to stop off again at that town.
She informs you she's going to go non-stop, but, you know, she'll ride with you till you have to stop.
Could we get anything we want for breakfast?
Yes, anything.
Anything!
What would you like for breakfast?
Cinnamon toast.
Done.
Laura would be like, 16 kilos of gold nuggets. Like that.
That's not food.
Nope.
It is when you're an alchemist.
No. If you want cinnamon toast and milk tea.
I never did change Nari's AC.
Yeah, she informs you she's going to leave for she's going to leave for the capital now. Also informing you can't really stay in the building because, you know, she's not going to be here.
Yeah.
Did Brifflin and Zoe find anything?
Yes, I'll PM you later what you exactly found out.
Let me know if we're having a good morning.
Yeah.
You found some stuff out.
Something good?
Is it, like, really interesting? Like, really
interesting.
Really good. Does it send us in a different direction? Like, do we go anywhere? Special, fancy.
You're probably searching a different subject than you were searching before.
Okay, it's good news, bad news.
You know, you've got something to research now, so maybe good news, depending on what you think.
Well,
I mean, there's no bad news. If that means anything to you.
Mm. Okay.
She basically kicks you out of the massive house.
Kicks you out. Well, yeah, she did take you in before you even know your names or...
That's true.
Like, you're gonna sleep in my beds and eat my food.
She doesn't have to kick us out, so we will walk freely, you know.
Yeah, the basic idea stands, and mm-hmm. She thanks you for bringing this to her attention. And she basically summons herself a horse and rides off. Which Laurel and Bullard see as she rides, and her horse, like, jumps down between the rocks.
And slowly Riff will follow.
I guess we're just going down to their camp.
Yeah.
Just cleaning up for breakfast.
It seems your associates have given me quite a bit to research, so I'm heading for the capital. Maybe I'll see you one day, maybe not.
Well, we tend to run into quite a few people. You should certainly hear my name when you go there.
Understood.
By the way, do you know what basilisk eggs go for recently?
I do not know the price myself, no. Did you kill one of the colonies out there?
Yes.
Well, have fun with those. A lot of people end up getting hurt by them quite badly.
Do you know anything of a big reptilian flying thing that hunts in this area?
Oh, that. Yes, I do know about said creature.
What is it?
Ballard pipes up and says, looked like a dragon to me, but it was far off and it was dark, so I couldn't tell exactly.
Well, that is not inaccurate.
It is a fucking dragon.
It is a It's been here longer than any notes I can find. It is a black dragon.
Shit.
Frowns his eye.
Longer I said than it any... was Telemundus.
Longer than any reports she can find means old. Maybe not in actual
age. I suppose that
category.
Means you should leave sooner rather than later.
He normally just flies around his area at the night, so it wouldn't mean normally when you're inside, you're normally quite safe. He seems to be quite docile when it comes to attacking, actually, us.
What?
As far as I know, Black Dragon is the alchemist's worst nightmare.
They are known for being exceptionally acidic.
Yes, and immune to the same. She said.
It's the reason my house might be made of slightly acid-proof bricks.
I suppose it's up to Rithland. If she requires us to stay, we'll stay.
I recommend staying on this side. Because at least here, if you hide within the cliff area, he normally doesn't notice this, but...
Ballard asks if she knows his name.
Telemundo.
There is some record of his name. I believe, I haven't really studied him myself, he's more just been a nuisance. But I believe his name is Shamanol Nightsbane.
Is that Ralarn for Jorathian?
What?
Ba-dang.
No.
That's Nightsbane.
No.
Ralarn is the language they speak in Emerisia.
That is not
we all know it.
That is not a special translation, just something.
It was a joke. Anyway.
Yes, he lives in the swamp on the far end of the mountain.
Yeah, Ballard will probably end up doing a little research then.
How?
I'm sure there's libraries we can access in the city, in Emerisia.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, tons.
Oh, yeah.
I thought it went here. I was like, huh?
No.
I mean, Laurel only brought books about plants, so. Nature.
I'm sure if he's been here for a long time, then there's something on him.
Yeah, a word of warning to you all is do not go to the swamp on the far side. He will find you very quickly.
What a douche. He's one of the
main reasons people disappear so often.
He's big enough to take out a fucking ship?
Yes. He can carry the ship if he so felt.
Chargamon!
Robots in... Wait, what?
Chargamon. Dragons in other campaigns.
For Rithland?
What?
And well, with that news, should we head off? It was a long trip here, but...
Riff nods and says, yeah, with something like that thing around, yeah, maybe.
Did you find what you were looking for?
I certainly found something.
Do you feel like your business here is ended, or would you rather stay?
For now?
I understand if you do not wish to return with us.
I don't know. Riff doesn't feel any... Like, does Nairu feel like he wants to stay?
No, Nairu is scared of hell of the dragon.
I suppose, alright. Alright, yeah, I guess we'll just... Riff will say, yeah, there's no reason why we should hang around, I guess.
God, next level, I'm sure I'm going to talk to Nairu.
Time to pack up the camps, then. Secrets.
Yeah. Griff nods and says, yeah, help.
Everyone can have some elk on the way back.
Or ferret, or basilisk.
There wasn't really much
that?
In the way of ferret.
I think Ballard's eaten the whole ferret.
Oh, yeah, I probably
there's not a lot of meat on that one.
Did Ballard say that?
No.
I think the basilisk probably isn't. This is stew. You don't really save that.
You might have some cubes of elk. But...
So he looks, looks a little disgusted, and you ate that.
Well, look at the elk.
Ate what?
Says,
basilisk
yes.
For the elk.
Good venison, good for you.
Okay, I guess both.
Does Zoe not eat any meat? Is she vegetarian?
Yeah, I guess
she's
so.
She's one of those really rude vegetarians that tries to force her beliefs on everyone.
Oh my god, you ate that?
No, but it's kind of gross.
Did you really eat that living creature?
Yeah, I guess she would definitely be a vegetarian after all the torture she's been
but
through
it's
with the
not,
animals.
It was dead when we found it, though.
Yeah, well, that's why it's gross.
Every animal you eat is dead.
Anyway, I guess she would be more... No, the basilisk, I guess.
Well, Frown, he knows he's eaten much more gross things than that to survive through his life. Of course, he knows also that she means nothing by it. He just wanted the silver spoon in her mouth.
Manekai, I didn't say any of those things before. The only thing I said, I guess, the basilisk. Did you eat that?
The basilisk, yeah. Well, I mean, Laurel didn't eat a whole lot because he doesn't need to.
A basilisk?
Yeah, you gotta... I mean, you killed it, you gotta eat it.
Yeah, Bard, it was good. It was tough, but the stew, the broth, made it a little less tough, and it was, you know, nice and chewy. And it tasted like chicken.
Alright, so we head off. Does Laurel want to stop off at that town again? To be honest, Riff doesn't... She's not too interested in it anymore.
Really? She's not? Well...
Like, not right now, she's just... Her fucking hawk turned glowing, man, come on. She don't give a shit about some crazy town with growing shit. Her hawk's crazy awesome now, like...
Dude, there would be blood all over the camp! And you're cutting up basilisk.
Oh, they don't do it in the middle of the camp.
No, you do it off to the side, it's
dead. Yeah, and you wash it in the lake and everything. Yeah.
Besides, even if there was blood everywhere, so what? We've been in battles where there's more blood than that.
That's true.
You, like, yeah. Drain
like
them.
Six city guard.
You guys are terrible.
Terrible?
Yeah.
Laurel just eats stuff that can be eaten because that's how you survive when you're really poor.
You're adding the city guards.
I don't eat those.
No, but you killed the city guards.
You were there. You helped.
Yeah.
She only healed.
Yeah, you're still assisting us in our slaughter of guards.
Well, she had to.
Yeah, it was mostly to keep Zoe's identity secret.
Though. It would have helped. We wouldn't have been caught.
Zoe is an accomplice.
We wouldn't have got caught if we had just left.
Yeah,
tell them about that lady in the...
It was all about it. You didn't do any of it for so. You did it just to see who the lady was in the tree.
No, I did not to rat her out.
Yes, sheep, we will go to the mountain, wave, and have a conversation with the giant black dragon.
We're not going to have a conversation with a black dragon.
No, Laura at least isn't. He is, he's going home. You know,
the lady
nice as the trip was, you know, they had their one night of sleeping in the forest. And that was apparently worth the like, week-long, 14 days trip.
Dude,
week-long
we could
trip.
Get it whatever we wanted to eat in the manor. Got cinnamon toast.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we head back.
Stew. It's great.
It's pretty.
So he frowns.
We head back to the city. The city. Let's go.
Laurel will sort of comment on Paul's cooking. He's never been much of a cook himself, really. His mother mostly did the cooking. But maybe he should learn. You know, it would be useful. I mean, he can cook for survival, but not...
Ballard only knows how to cook meat.
To make it an art.
Like, he'll eat vegetables, but he doesn't know anything about preparing them. But he's damn good at meat preparation.